Hi, I recently stumbled upon an interesting laser at a thrift store. It is advertised as an 808 nanometers laser, powerful enough to remove hair. But how powerful is it? On the box, the only sign of the laser's power is a tiny warning, almost hidden on the bottom. It says class 1 laser. Really? Class 1 is the safest, completely harmless class. How can it remove hair then? This seems a bit strange to me. Let's measure the actual power and wavelength of this laser. What is going on? When experimenting with a laser, wear safety glasses suitable for its wavelength and power output, especially when using invisible infrared lasers. I bought this laser for only 100 Danish kroner. Being second-hand, the laser came without any papers or DVD instructions. But as far as I can tell, it dates back to 2011 and is no longer manufactured. If this unit has been used for up to 13 years, it might have lost some or most of its power. But before we test how strong it is, I want to measure the color spectrum of the four diodes built into the laser head. Yes, four. There are two different laser diodes inside. When the handpiece is unlocked, using a key and security combination, an LED emitting visible light turns on. Its light is centered around an uncommon 594 nanometers. Orange color to my eyes, but could pass as yellow-orange or even yellow. I have videos about yellow lasers you can watch later. The lasers inside the handpiece will, however, not turn on when only the orange LED is lit. The two electrodes need to touch skin before the lasers can be activated. Now a white LED turns on. This emits a bluish-white light, where the blue LED under the phosphor coating is very prominent in the light spectrum. Next up are the lasers. With the button half-pressed, a red guide laser turns on. It is clearly a 650 nanometers type. Nice! More visible to our eyes at low power than the older, cheaper 660 to 670 nanometers types. Last but not least, the hair blasting laser. The near infrared 808 nanometers laser mentioned on the box. Is it 808 nanometers? Not quite. More like 800 nanometers. Seems low to me, since 808 nanometer laser diodes are usually only off by plus minus 3, maybe 4 nanometers, not 8. Let me zoom in on the spectrum with the pointer set at 808 nanometers. Okay, this one is apparently off by 7.5 nanometers. Or did something happen to the calibration of my spectrometer? Hopefully not. I have another 808 nanometers laser measured to be close to spec earlier. And it still is. Phew! Nothing wrong with the spectrometer. So the hair removal laser is really around 800 nanometers. Odd. After a little googling, I did find some diodes that can be up to plus minus 10 nanometers off from the factory. They would suck as a pump diode in a green 532 nanometers DPSS laser that needs to be close to 808 nanometers for best efficiency. But for removing hair, 8 nanometers off makes little to no difference. If anything, it makes the laser slightly more visible. Yes, visible, even though infrared above 700 to 750 nanometers is usually considered invisible. But if the near infrared is intense enough, our eyes can see it. I have a video about it, but in short, the camera records the 800 nanometers from this laser as violet. To my eyes, it is a very dim, deep red color. That's eerie to me. I know infrared 800 nanometers has to be intense to be just faintly visible to my eyes. But for the unknowing, it may appear harmless because it is so dim. Time for an eye-opening demonstration. My camera can remove its IR filter to record near-infrared unfiltered. Here's how it records in normal mode using the IR cut filter. The infrared laser is recorded as weak violet light after being dimmed significantly by the infrared filter. Let me remove the IR filter. There we go. The filter is gone, and I'll turn off the room lights. How will the infrared laser look to the camera now? This laser packs a serious punch. We usually just can't see it. A less technical approach to visualizing its power is to just burn stuff. Seeing a laser this strong, I would not expect it to be class 1, the safest of all laser classes. How many milliwatts is this laser sending out? I will measure it after a short message. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. Your help with getting the laser pyrometer and spectrometer makes videos like this one possible. For just $1 a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link to my Patreon page in the description. Thank you. Alright, time to find out how powerful this laser is. There is a small challenge though. Laser power meters work by measuring how much they are heated up by a laser. The model I use needs up to 15 seconds to measure the full strength of the laser beam. But this laser will only run for max 3.5 seconds at the time, so some calculation is needed. Based on the 3 known data points, I have guesstimated these curves for my laser power meter. After only 3.5 seconds, it should reach around 80 to 85% of the laser beam's actual power. Good. With the LPM calibrated to 808 nanometers, close enough, I will start right at the laser's highest power setting, level 5 of 5. Here we go. Okay, 297 milliwatts after 3.5 seconds. That's a laser beam around 350 to 370 milliwatts. No wonder it can destroy hair roots. For confirmation, I tried a couple of times more, with very consistent results. Nice. Actually, I have another way of confirming the measurements. My patrons have already seen me unbox, figure out, and open up this laser for a minor repair. Inside, on the circuit board, is a sticker with the factory's measurements of the laser's power. I did not spoil it to my patrons, but will reveal it now. 372 milliwatts at 539 milliamps. The laser has lost little to no power since 2011. Awesome! But what about the lower power settings? How strong are they? This looks confusing and illogical, but you may have spotted something. The laser seems to have the same brightness, power, every time it is turned on. But by turning it on and off repeatedly, the total energy delivery over the 4 seconds run is different for each setting. In other words, the delivered energy is not changed by changing the laser's brightness, but by pulsing it. This unit has an energy setting, not a power setting. I have mapped the different energy settings using an infrared detector card. Notice how similar the total energies are between the stronger settings, but the heating effect is not, because the lower settings have a shorter main pulse, giving a lower peak temperature. This is all fine, but there is a remaining important question. Is this really a class 1 laser? Well, I am not an expert or trained laser safety officer, so I'm really not in a position to judge a complex one. But I can share my amateur thoughts and opinion. Notice how it does not say class 1 laser, but class 1 laser product. That makes a significant difference, which the average consumer may not realize. This class 1 laser product seems to contain a class 3B laser, based on wavelength and power alone. However, factors such as beam diameter, divergence, duration, and the intended use without bypass safety features also count in the classification. Is the embedded laser eye safe under normal, intended, reasonably foreseeable use? Probably yes. The skin sensors will, during intended use, make sure the laser beam cannot go directly into eyes. And since the beam is fairly divergent after being focused into a spot behind a plastic piece, it quickly loses intensity with distance. I wish the plastic would block infrared spillage as an extra safety feature, but it doesn't. Not a big issue, since skin and flesh do not reflect red and near-infrared light, like a mirror. If I point a weak red laser into my finger, while making sure it can't hit my eyes, you can see the red laser light going through my finger. Skin and flesh will not absorb red light well. It is mostly just scattered and diffused to low intensity. Do not try this with lasers of other colors though. Your skin will absorb their energy and quickly heat up into a burn, especially for violet and blue lasers. For the 800 nanometers infrared, it is the same story as with red. My pale skin is not absorbing the energy, just diffusing and scattering it all over the place. In nightshot mode, my finger, well, phones home, if you know what I mean. But I don't feel any heating of my skin. Only dark hairs will quickly absorb the infrared energy and get hot. So the laser seems quite skin safe too, unless you are not as pale as me, or hit a birthmark, mole or tattoo. I wish this old unit came with a built-in skin tone sensor, like more modern versions. I can't help but think you could burn your skin even under the intended use, questioning the class 1 laser product rating. But once again, I have to remember this one dates back to 2011. Under modern classification, this would likely be a class 1C laser product, a class that wasn't introduced until 2015, 4 years after this laser was made. So all in all, it was probably correctly labeled for its time. But as always, don't bypass safety features and make your own safety assessments. Many laser pens are mislabeled and without any safety features at all. I have an example in an old video. Hope you liked this video enough to click like and perhaps subscribe for more like it. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.